फ्रॉम टैंक रोड एमपीएस सेकेंडरी स्कूल भांडुप. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद आवर लेसन दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न्ड बट फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज इट वंस अगेन. सो द लेसन नेम इज लाइफ प्रोसेसेस इन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. ओके सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन दिस इज ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इन प्लांट ट्रांसपोर्टेशन in plant. So before starting, once again we'll revise what is the difference between living organism and non-living organism. So the living organism, we can understand that the difference, a big difference between living and non-living, are living are alive and non-living are not alive. Okay, so living things can breathe, living things can grow, living things can reproduce, living things can see, all the things are that can, the living thing can move, these are the living things. And non-living things, they cannot see, they cannot hear, they cannot move, they cannot grow, they cannot reproduce. So this is the main most important thing. So the life processes which are conducted inside the living organism's body, these are called as life processes, and these are different types of life processes. Let us learn something. So the life, different life processes you can see in front of life are nutrition, transportation, respiration, excretion, reproduction, and metabolism. So what is nutrition? From where we get our nutrition, nutrients? So we get our nutrition from our food. In that we can get carbohydrates, protein, fats, minerals, vitamins, fibers, all the rubbish from the food items that are very much necessary for our body to grow, right? So this is the life processes. It's a process inside our body. Then transportation. Transportation means what? So transportation means the blood that is transported in all the body. It transports or it supplies oxygen to each and every part of the body. So all these things comes inside this transportation. What is respiration? Respiration means what? The air we breathe inside, means oxygen we are breathing inside. So this oxygen goes from nose inside our lungs, right? Windpipe, through windpipe inside the lungs, through bronchioles, and the process gets start, and then the oxygen gets mixed with our blood. Then from the blood circulates this, takes this oxygen to each and every part of our body. And then again, if the the deoxygenated blood, means deoxygenated blood, gives carbon dioxide throughout our body. So we exhale carbon dioxide and we inhale oxygen in this process. So this is also a type of life processes inside our body. Then excretion, whatever the excretion, excretory the parts are, the excretory material, unwanted parts, which is not required by our body, is excreted from our blood. So it is a process which helps during the digestion of food. So this is excretion, and during the urine formation also. Then again, reproduction, to make the same kind of same kind of its own is called as reproduction, right? So man give birth to man only, plants is reproduced like a plant only, right? So animal give birth to animal only. So these are the reproduction system which has in also, it is a life process which has inside the body. Again, metabolism, the food we eat is get digested into our body, right? So all these things comes in that metabolism. So all these are the life processes that helps in our body are nutrition, transportation, respiration, excretion, reproduction, and metabolism. So what we are going to learn in this are transportation. We have already learned, but today again we are going to revise it. So transportation, transportation in plants, transportation of water in plants. So what is root pressure, transpiration pool, and transportation of food and other substances in the plant. So all these things we are going to learn. So see, before that, let us start with something. So how do we digest? See, digested food or oxygen inhaled by lungs is transported to every cell of the body. So how it happens? See, we will get one example. So you have seen, farmer also tries to transport the water from wells or dams through a main channel to every plant. You can see in the picture, some sources are there through which water is reaches to each required part of the plant or field or wherever. So you can see one pump is there, then irrigation system is seen, and then dams are also there. Through which what happens, the farmer take the water and it supplies to his fields to get the proper yield. Okay, so in this, what happens? The food, so likewise only, the food absorbed by the digestive system is also converted into the energy. And this energy and oxygen are both transported via blood throughout the body. So likewise, how the transportation helps, we know that transportation, what is the meaning of this transportation? To take something from one place to another. So likewise, also inside the plant body or human body, this transportation takes place. Before going ahead, let us revise something, that how do the digestive system and respiratory system work? We know that how digestive system works. In digestive system, you can see the different organs are there, like mouth and mouth cavity is there, through which we are taking food inside, and we are chewing it with the help of our teeth and tongue, right? And then it goes towards pharynx. Then esophagus means a food pipe, through which it goes into the stomach, where some part of the food nutrient can absorb, through which the remaining parts goes into the small intestine. Over there, some part of the protein molecules are absorbed. Again, the remaining part is go into the large intestine, and where water and minerals are absorbed, and the remaining part, which is not required by our body, get thrown out from the body through the rectum and end. So this is the process, and this is the system inside the body. This is the digestive system. And how respiratory system works, we have already learned that we have nasal cavity to inhale oxygen inside our body. Through that, it goes towards the larynx. Then through larynx, the food windpipe, and through there it goes into the trachea, and through that it goes into the bronchus, bronchi, alveoli, through which what happens, it transports this oxygen into the bloodstream, and through which again it reaches to each and every part of the body, and again the oxygenated, deoxygenated blood comes in over, and again the CO2 comes into alveoli, then bronchial, again through larynx, and it goes outside. We exhale carbon dioxide outside. So this is a type. This is the things digestive system and respiratory system works inside our body. So likewise, only it is also a type of transportation. So what farmer do? Farmer tries to transport the water from the wells and then to main channel. So likewise, food absorbed by the digestive system is also converted into energy. And again, this energy and oxygen both transported via blood throughout the body. So it reaches to each and every part of the body. Now, what is transportation? The main definition of transportation: by the process of transportation, a substance either synthesized or absorbed in one part of the body reaches to. So the transportation is, it's like a process in which any of the substance is synthesized or absorbed by one part can reach us to each and every part of it. We have learned about the meaning of transportation. This is something we need to transport it from one place to another. If you want to come to school or go to home, what happened? We are taking one transport, any type of transport. We can take bicycle also, an auto rickshaw, or any bus, or our local train. So what happens? It takes us from one place to another. So likewise, transportation means what? Transportation is a type of a process in which a substance either synthesized or absorbed in one part of the body reaches to another part of the body, which is required. Okay, so this is the meaning of definition of transportation. So some few questions. Before going ahead, let us discuss something like transportation in plants. Why do we eat fruits and vegetables? Why are we eating fruits and vegetables? What is the need of this eating fruits and vegetables? Through these fruits and vegetables, we get vitamins and minerals, which are required by our body. And what happened after that? It gives energy to our body. It helps in growing of our damaged tissues also. It helps in all the things. It can manage your metabolism also. So these fruits and vegetables are all very much important. So they, from these fruits and vegetables, we get minerals. So from where do these, the plants also get need minerals like we do? Do they need? Yes, they need the minerals like we do to grow. To grow. Likewise, we get these minerals from fruits and vegetables. So fruits and vegetables, vegetables also get it from somewhere. So let us see if from where it gets its minerals. So from where do the plants get inorganic substances other than CO2 and O2? CO2 and O2, we have learned that from where we are getting, we are taking oxygen from plants and we are giving out carbon dioxide to the plant. And what plants are doing with the CO2? With the help of this CO2, they make their own food, okay? In the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, okay? So this is the process in which, so the inorganic substance, from where they will take, let us see from where they will take this inorganic substance. See, you can see some minerals are shown over there, some vegetables are given, fruits are given, some foodstuffs are given. Okay, so the fruits which are given, like we can get magnesium, sodium, potassium, iron from these food sources. I mean, these are the rich sources which we need to eat every day to get healthy in life. Okay, so these are the mineral rich. All these are mineral, magnesium, sodium, potassium, iron are the minerals, and we get it from fruits and vegetables. So see, you can see one another picture over there. In there, it is given essential mineral elements. So see, you can see that a plant is there. Below that, it is down deep into the soil. Roots are there. In that root, you can see potassium, then nitrogen, H2O symbols are given. From that roots only, from the soil only, these plants get these minerals. And these minerals are transported in each of the plant to make their own. Okay? So minerals are almost required, and plants get these minerals from the soil. So most animals move from place to place, but plants do not. Plants cannot move from one place to another place. As we are animals, so we can move from one place to another. But plants do not move from one place to another. There are many dead cells in the plant. So due to that, what happens? There are many dead cells are there. They need less energy as compared to energy. Why they need less energy? Because they cannot move. Na. The energy that is required to moving is there inside the animal. So they require much more energy. But plants do not require much more energy. Plants need inorganic substances like nitrogen. They require, see, you can see in the picture, nitrogen is there, phosphorus, magnesium, then sodium, right? See, a carbon atom is there, then carbon molecule, hydrogen, oxygen is there, magnesium is there, sodium is there. All these things are taken by plants from the soil. The soil is the nearest and richest source of these substances. From soil, we get all these minerals. We get minerals from plants and fruits, vegetables, and these vegetables and plants and fruits get these minerals from the soil. Roots of the plant absorb these substances from the soil. It absorbs the substances from the soil and transport them to each and every part of the plant till the leaf end. There are specific type of tissues to perform this function. As we know, we have learned that for the irrigation purpose, what farmer is doing, he is using a type of pipes are there. So pipes, some source is there, right? Which transport the water from one place to each and every place in the farm, right? Likewise, in the plants also a type of pipes are there, which are called conducting tissue. These are called conducting tissue, and its names are xylem and phloem. Let us learn about that. Okay, so these are the vessels, like a pipe or a cylindrical substances. You can see a structure is there. In that, one is xylem vessel and one is phloem vessel, which together we called as conducting tissue. So the xylem conducts the water, whereas the phloem conducts the oxygen. See what happens when the plant is there inside the soil. The roots are there downside. So what will happen towards the roots? The roots absorb the minerals, magnesium, sodium, whatever is required by the plant body is absorbed by the roots, and then it transported from that minerals. The water, with water, the minerals all automatically comes up, right? So water and minerals, the xylem vessel, the name of the vessel is called a xylem vessel. transport this water and minerals to each and every part of the body. You can see that an arrow going upward. It means that the water and minerals are absorbed by the roots, are transported from one part of the plant to each and every part of the plant body. So it is one way, and the water and mineral molecules, you can see over there, no end walls between cell walls. Cell walls are no ended, and thick walls are there, right, with lignin. So these are the called as conducting tissue. Then what is the phloem tissue, phloem vessel, what? So when the water reaches into the leaf, we know that leaf is the food factory of plant, means it is a type of kitchen for the plants only. So what will happen over there, in the kitchen of the plant, in the leaves itself, photosynthesis process occurs. What is the meaning of this photosynthesis? Means plant makes their own food with the help of what? With the help of water, mineral, in the presence of, with the help of carbon dioxide, water and minerals, in the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight. So water is there, water reaches to the plant, a leaf of the plant. Over there, it makes its food, and again it transport the food to each and every part of the plant because it is required. So the vessel which is used to transport the food to each and every part of the plant is nothing but the phloem vessel. It is called as phloem. So what xylem is doing? Xylem is transporting the water from root to each and every part, and phloem transported the food atom plus the water molecule to each and every part of the plant. So it is a two way. Xylem vessel is a one-way process, means it is going upward only. But phloem is both the way flow. Means water and minerals are also going, and the food atom is also transporting to each and every part of the plant. So these are the conducting vessels, conducting tissues, we can call it as. So xylem and phloem are there, which very much important. Like we have our nerves inside our body, likewise they have xylem and phloem. Xylem, what xylem is doing? Xylem transporting the water from roots to each and every part of the plant, means towards the leaf. And where the leaf, in leaf, the food is prepared, and that food is again transported to each and every plant with the help of this phloem vessel. Let us go ahead. You can see a picture over there. The red color part is xylem and blue color part is phloem. So you can see it is a one way and phloem is two way. Downside, you can see a plant. Plant's roots are shown from where the red color portion is water and minerals are absorbed by the roots, and it goes upward towards the leaf. And over the leaf, what happened? The food is prepared with the help of the photosynthesis, again with the help of these blue vessels, means the phloem, it reaches to each and every part of the plant. So you can see in between xylem and phloem, conducting tissues are there. And in that, between, you can see a cambium is there. It is a portion which is called as cambium. Its outermost part is epidermis, then cortex, teeth, and cambium. And then xylem and phloem is shown. Now, transportation of water in plants. So how can we understand this? How we need to do a practical experiment to know that how the plant water is transported to each and every part of the plant. See, you can see one experiment is given in front of you. In that, what we need to do is, say, we need to take a small plant like balsam with its roots intact. One plant is there, we need to take this plant like tuberose or balsam, we can say. And what we need to do is, we need to clean its, wash and clean its roots. Then we need to keep it in the water containing a stain like safranin or isum. It is a red color. So due to that only, what we will see that how water can transfer from roots to leaf. After leaving, we need to keep it inside that vessel which is which contain that stain safranin or isum. So when we dip it inside, we need to keep it for 2 to 3 hours. What we will observe that the xylem vessel appear red from the rest. See, what is the function of the xylem vessel? Xylem vessel transport carry the water and minerals from the absorbed roots to each and every part of the plant. So whatever part is there of xylem, it will become red color due to the safranin or ESA. likewise it is taking upward na, it is one way we know that. So likewise the red color water or the saccharine conducted water is going upward, and we can understood by this that, and they are stained by the dye because root pressure is the force that drives water and nutrients into xylem upward through the plant. It transport it in the upward direction. Through this particular picture, we can understood that, see, water and minerals are transported to each and every part of the plant. So this is a small practical. You can do it at home also to know this. And this is always, so it is a pressure. So type of a pressure is there. Okay. Now again, how absorption with the help of roots are taken. You can see over there a leaf is shown over there. In that also you can see water transport. Xylem is shown over there. So how from the root system you can see the water goes upward, then it pressurizes, pressure, it gets pressure force exerted over there, and the water reaches to each and leaves towards the leaf. How root cells are in contact with water. We know that root cells are always in contact with water because it is downside, it is inside the soil only. And in the soil, what happens? Soil absorbs water and minerals in the soil. Water and mineral enter the cells on the root surface due to the difference in concentration. Difference in concentration helps over there, and due to this only water and minerals enters in the cell. So as a result, these cells become turgid. It becomes turgid. It becomes turgid. These turgid cells exert pressure on the adjacent cells. Adjacent cell, whatever cells are there, adjacent means with them, beside them, na, it exert pressure on that. And what happens to this? This is called as root pressure. This is called as root pressure. It pressures the roots, and again the water goes ahead. Like under the effect of this pressure, water and minerals reach the xylem of the roots, and to reduce this difference in concentration, they are continuously pushed forward. Continuously pushed forward by this turgidity and exerting pressure. As a result of this continuous movement, a water column is formed, which is continuously pushed ahead. Water column formed and which is continuously pushed ahead. And due to this, what will happen? The xylem carry this water and minerals, and these water reaches to the last tip of the leaf. This pressure is sufficient to lift the water up in shrubs, small plants, and small trees. Means it happens only in shrubs, small plants, and small trees. So trees are having bigger xylems and phloem, so that they require much more pressure to do this. Okay. Now, see, let us learn about something. We need to do one more practical over there. Take a medium-sized well water plant. We need to take a well water plant. A plant is there with the vase, and inside that soil is there. Inside that plant is shown over there. So what will happen? It is watered, well-watered plant. Cover the plant with a transparent polythene bag. We need to cover the plant leaf with a transparent polythene bag, completely in tight mouth around the base of the stem. And we need to tie it around the base of the stem. You know, means not a single micron space should be there to the air to go inside or come outside. Take a similar empty polythene bag and tie its mouth. Again, we need to take a similar polythene bag. Keep the plant as well as the empty polythene bag in sunlight. We need to keep the empty polythene bag and the tied polythene bag in sunlight for 1 to 2 hours. What will happen? Plants give out water in the form of vapor through the stomata on their leaves. See, we know that evaporation, transpiration process helps inside the plants. Whatever water is absorbed by the plant through the roots is in the whole part of the plant, and through which what will happen when sunlight comes, then due to this heat energy, what will happen? The water will transfer, evaporate upside. But what will happen? And evaporate and it goes into the atmosphere. But what will happen when we tie this polythene bag around it? The steam or the evaporation that is produced cannot move or go ahead beyond the polythene bag. And so what will happen? So the vapors through the stomach, vapors are formed inside the polythene bag. So due to this, we can conclude that in leaves are having small small opening on their body, which are called as on the surface of the plant. One side it is called as stomata. Like we are having pores on our skin, na, through which our body produces sweat, na. So likewise, plants are also having stomata. Through that, what will happen? The water goes out in the form of vapor. See, you can see stomata. Pictures of stomatas are there. In that, what is there? Guard cells are there, which guards the stomata. And chloroplast is there. Chloroplast is the plant organelle which is present only in the plant cell. So these are the guard cells. So when it opens, it gives out vapors, and when it closes, it does not. Like you can see a stomata that is open and stomata that is closed. So plant gives out water in the form of vapor through the stomata on their leaves. Two cells called guard cells are also present around the stomata. These cells control the opening and closing of the stomata. These guard cells control the opening and closing of stomata. Transpiration occurs through this stomata. Transpiration is what we know that. Well, the water gives out by the plants in the form of vapor are called as transpiration. So water is released into the atmosphere by leaves through the process of evaporation. So water is brought up to the leaves through the xylem. We know that we have already done one practical, and we have already learned that xylem is the conducting tissue which carry the water from roots to each and every part of the plant. Then, as a result, water level in the epidermal layer of the leaf decreases. The water level decreases. Then water is brought up to the leaves through the xylem as to compensate to the loss of water. So to recover this loss of water, again what will happen? The leaf carries the xylem again push the water forward, and again it fulfills the water requirement. Transpiration helps in absorption of water and minerals and distribution to all parts of the plant. There is good pressure performs the important role of pushing the water up during the night time. See, transpiration, absorption of mineral and water, we know that, and distribution to each and every part of plant. Where is what good pressure is doing when night time is there? Again, it pushes the water to upward. See, this is transpiration. You can see in the picture in front, a plant is given, roots are also there. So root takes up water from the soil. We know that how it takes. The blue color arrows are shown like it is water, and it goes upward. Water is drawn up the stem to the leaves. Right, in stem we know that which conducting tissue is present, xylem and phloem are present. Xylem, what is the function of this xylem? Xylem carry the water or water from roots to each and every part of the plant. So it goes towards the plant leaf tip, and water evaporates from the leaf through stomata. We know that stomatas are present over there. Then transportation of food and other substances. Transportation of food and other substances, we know that the food producing leaves, again we know that xylem and phloem are two conducting tissues through which through xylem, what will happen? The water goes absorbed by the roots of the plant, goes to each and every part of the plant. Again, leaf, what are the function of the leaf? It is called as food factory of the plant, where the food is made for the plant, which is required for the growth. So what will happen over there? So this food is again transported to each and every part of the plant through phloem. So the food produced in leaves is transported to each cell in the plant body. Excess food, except amino acid, is stored in roots and seeds. The excess food, whatever is there, except amino acid, is stored in roots, fruits, and seeds. And as a result, we eat the fruit and seeds. This process is called as translocation. This process is called as translocation of the material. It is carried out in both the upward and downward directions by the phloem. We know that it is two ways. Xylem is one way and phloem is two way. Translocation of materials is not simple physical process. It is not a simple physical process, but it requires energy. See, for xylem, it does not require energy because due to the exerting pressure, the water goes upward. Okay, but here in phloem, to transport the food atom, it is also two-way, so it requires energy. And which type of energy? The energy is obtained from ATP, adenosine triphosphate molecule. Whenever food material like sucrose is transported towards a part of plant via phloem with the help of ATP, the water concentration decreases in that part. Water concentration automatically decreases in that part. So what will happen? As a result, water enters the cell by the process of diffusion. As a result, water enters the cell into the process of diffusion. The pressure on the cell wall increases due to the increase in cellular content. Cellular content. So due to the increased pressure, food is pushed into the neighboring cells where the pressure is low. And this process helps the phloem to transport the materials as per the need of the plant. So during flowering season, the sugar stored in the roots or stem is transported towards the floral buds to make them open and blossom. Open and blossom. See, you can see that energy is obtained from adenosine triphosphate at the ATP. It's short for ATP. Over there, you can see sieve tubes means phloem is there, which is two-way and it requires ATP molecule, right? Then due to facilitated diffusion, it transports all the food atom from one part of the plant to another plant. Now, during flowering season, the sugar stored in roots or stem is transported towards the floral buds to make them open. We know that during the flowering season, what will happen? Flowers blossoms are there, blossom season is there. So how this happened? We have already learned that the store accepts amino acid. All the other food part is stored in roots and seeds. Which type of roots we eat like beetroot are there, then carrot we can eat, radish we can eat. So these are the roots which are having this food atom, which is in that energy is required, which is energy required. Then fruits, whatever fruits are there, and when it is ripened fully, we eat that because the whatever the excess food is that it is stored over there. Then seeds are also, we eat the seeds also, like dry fruits, we know that the almonds are there, the cashew nuts are there. So these are the seeds which we eat, right? So these things are the transportation of food and other substances in the plant, okay? So let us revive once again what we have already learned, that transportation process is there. What do you mean by the transportation? By the process of transportation, a substance either synthesized or absorbed in one part of the plant reaches to another part of the plant. So what will happen? Most moving animals move from place to place, but plants do not move from one place to another place. So plants require less energy as compared to that. Animals require more energy for moving. So plants need inorganic. So plants need this inorganic substance like nitrogen, phosphorus, magnesium, manganese, sodium, etc. And from where it takes from the soil. And so the soil is the richest, nearest and richest source of all these substances. So root of the plant absorb these substances from the soil and transport them to each and every part. So there are specific type of tissues to perform this function called as xylem and phloem, right? So xylem conducts the water, whereas the phloem conducts the food. And all the parts of the plants are connected with this conducting tissue. Now, transpiration of water, we have already learned about the root pressure, how root pressure is, and the water goes ahead. So root cells are in contact with water and minerals in the soil. Water and minerals enter the cells on the root surface due to the difference in concentration. As a result, what will happen? The cells become turgid. And due to this turgidity, cells exert pressure on the adjacent cells, and this is called as root pressure. So under the effect of this pressure, water and minerals reach the xylem of the roots, and to reduce this difference in concentration, they continuously push forward. As a result of this continuous movement, a water column is formed, which is continuously pushed ahead. This pressure is sufficient to lift the water up in the shrub, small plants, and small trees. Then transpiration pool, we have learned about the transpiration pool. So plants give out water in the form of vapor through the stomata on their leaves. Two cell guards are also present over there. These cells control the opening and closing of the stomata. Transpiration occurs through this stomata. water is released into the atmosphere by leaves through the process of evaporation. As a result, water level in the epidermal layer of the leaf decreases. Water is also brought up to the leaves through the xylem so as to compensate the loss of water. Transpiration helps in absorption of water and minerals and distribution of all parts of the plant, whereas root pressure performs the important role of pushing the water up during the night. Then transportation. The food produced in leaves is transported to each cell in the plant body. So it happens how? It happens with the help of phloem only. We know that phloem is also a conducting tissue which conducts or which carries the food atom to each and every part of the body. So excess food except amino acids, it's stored into the root and fruits and seeds. It is also called as translocation. And it is carried out in both the upward and downward direction by the phloem. So translocation of material is not simple physical process. It requires energy, which the energy is obtained by ATP, means adenosine triphosphate. So whenever food material like sucrose is transported towards the part of a plant via the phloem with the help of ATP, the water concentration decreases in that part. As a result, what will happen? Water enters in the cell by the process of diffusion, and the process on the cell wall increases due to the increase in cellular contents. Due to this increased pressure, food is pushed into the neighboring cells, whereas the pressure is used. This process helps the phloem to transport the material as per the need of the plant. And during the flowering season, what will happen? The sugar stored in the roots or stem is transported towards the floral buds. So what will happen? It makes them open and blossom. So till this, we have learned so all these points. So now evaluation, one homework is that you need to describe the transportation system in plant. You need to give the definition of transportation. So what is the definition of transportation? By the process of transportation, a substance either synthesized or absorbed in one part of the body reaches another. Again, you need to explain how this transportation helps with the help of conducting tissue, xylem is there and phloem is there. Then you need to write a note on root pressure, how the pressure root exerts the pressure on the adjacent walls and force the water to go up. Now you need to draw a well-labeled diagram. In that you need to draw guard cells also, chloroplast also, and you need to show all this. Now here we have already learned with this. So today what we have learned about transportation in plants, transportation of water in plants, transpiration pool, translocation. Okay, so transpiration pool means what? Again, we will see that with the help of this conducting tissue, what will happen? The water goes out, right? So it pulls upward to each and every part of the plant from xylem. And the flow, what will happen in translocation? The food item that is prepared by the leaf sent to each and every part of the plant. So till this, it's done here or there, and in next lesson we will proceed further. We'll do our next half of the part. Okay. Hello.